Dear brothers, happy to meet you online. This meeting is made possible by the blessings of technology in the context of pandemic that humans have created by exploiting the environment. We have the privileges of technology and resources to meet our personal needs, whereas the poor who have been caring for the environment stand affected the worst. The conditions of the exploited environment and the people in the context of JPIC mission reminds me about the parable of Good Samaritan. After telling the story, Jesus asked, which of these three was neighbor to the man? They replied, the one who had mercy on him. Then Jesus told him, go and do likewise. I understand that this is one of the mission commissions of Jesus to us. We are commissioned by Jesus to go and to work compassionately to the people and the planet. Good Samaritan mission of Father Claret. Father Claret received the mission mandate to serve as Archbishop in Cuba. We are able to read that his work in Cuba was that of Good Samaritan. In the first report that he sent to the Queen, he writes, I have traveled, dear madam, a great part of my vast diocese. I have sensed directly the wounds of these people. I have studied its evil results. I have discovered their origin. During his time in Cuba, there were only sugarcane, tobacco, and coffee plantations. Monoculture was pursued as against small diversified farming. Slavery was in practice. During those years, the Cuban population was more than 1 million and 43.5% of them were slaves from Africa. There was prohibition of interracial marriage. This resulted in the concubinage between the foreigners and the Cuban native women. Claret found this as a serious problem because the foreigners were abandoning their native women and their children and returned to their countries suddenly. Claret was convinced that education was an important requirement for social transformation, and so he started education institutions. For the abandoned children, he started House of Charity. To save the people from moneylenders, he started Credit Union. To promote indigenous cultivation, he advocated land for the small farmers, and he produced literature on how to do cultivation of various crops. To promote environment, he fought against the indiscriminate felling of trees and advocated planting of fruit and timber trees. He worked for the dignity of slaves and fought for interracial marriage. His mission did not carry the label JPIC, but it was considered as a regular mode of mission. During those years, almost in all the places, the missionaries were working for social development and transformation. But in the course of time, the missionaries forgot the mission mandate to be compassionate neighbors and got drowned in the institutions and rituals. So, the Vatican II proposed to create an organism in the church that would work for development and social justice. So Pope Paul VI established Pontifical Commission for Justice and Peace. It is now known as Pontifical Council for Justice and Peace. The unions of superior generals in 1982 formed the Commission for Justice, Peace and Integrity of Creation, JPIC, adding the phrase integrity of creation. This is how our congregation too, we have secretariat for JPIC. The purpose of JPIC is to remind ourselves of the missionary mandate to be neighbors to the suffering people and the planet. Mission Good Samaritan in the congregation. I have only a limited knowledge of the congregation. At the same time, I feel happy that we can be legitimately happy about the prophetic mission being done in the various parts of the congregation. I share here the little information known to me. I'm sure that you will have more opportunities to know about the transformative apostolates that is taking place in the congregation today among the refugees and migrants. The General Curia accommodates two refugee youths. Clara Tenaya, Euskaleria, receives and accompanies refugees. The Casa Claret in Vic, which serves the refugees, carries the caption, "Our house is your house, come." In Santiago province, Claret School at Fuen Santa, Valencia, is run exclusively for the refugees. The Casa Sul Pozzo in Lecco, Italy, serves the refugees, having lay people as principal agents of mission, promotion of holistic health. As per the request of our General Council, an inquiry was done on the practice of holistic health in the congregation. It was heartening to know that various types of alternative health systems are practiced in the major organisms of Central America, Chennai, Colombia, Venezuela, Colombia, Ecuador, Kolkata, Mexico, Santos Paulus, Catalonia, Sri Lanka, St. Charles, Luanga, and Fatima, Zimbabwe. Interreligious prayer and dialogue. Intolerance to religions is a cause for the disturbance of peace today. Almost all the Claretian refugee centers, particularly Claret Enaya, Casa Claret, Casa Sul Pozzo, are promoting interreligious dialogue. In the Philippines, dialogue mission has been for a long time. The Center for Interiorization in Valencia, Claret Amaydiyagam in Chennai, the practice of yoga, transcendental meditations in Hogares Claret in Mikla promote peace and inner engineering. Human rights mission. In Asia and Africa, our mission is mostly among the poor and the needy. In Mikla, human rights works are promoted explicitly. Costa Rica does advocacy for the rights of Bibris people. Colombia, Ecuador works for the defense of human rights defenders. Peru, Bolivia has worked to prevent violence against women, and Argentina works among the Mapuche indigenous people. Good Samaritan mission towards the future. We have the mission obligation to continue the Good Samaritan mission of our Claret and the congregation. To take this to the future, we need further to qualify ourselves in the realms of spirituality and the skills for doing mission. Contemplative prayer. Prayer was central in the life of Jesus. The mission mantra of Jesus was praying by night and preaching and healing by the day. For us too, the waiting on God gives power for mission. So, GPAC is a conscious prayer. One can become compassionate when there is a realization and experience that every life on earth shares the DNA of God. In fact, all forms of life resemble God. The book of Genesis says, God was moving over the face of the waters. The structure of atom coincides with what is said in the book of Genesis. In the atom, there is a nucleus which is in liquid state. In the nucleus, there is proton, which is energy, and neutron, which is neutral. The electron, the spirit, hovers over the nucleus. So, the structure of atom having proton and neutron in the nucleus and the electron hovering over the nucleus resembles the triune nature of God. And because of this, the first nuclear detonation done by Enrico Fermi in 1942 was named as Trinity. God created human by breathing his spirit in the mud fashioned by his hands. So, every person bears the fingerprint and the spirit of God. So, there is connection between the soul and the soil. Anthropocentrism arises in the absence of such an experience. Regular practice of personal prayer, particularly contemplative prayer, can be of great help in obtaining this experience. Contemplative eyes. Contemplation in prayer helps the missionaries to look at the world deeply and to analyze the society in the light of the gospel. The environmental reality. The planet Earth is devastated. Its chemistry, biosystems, geology, and the ozone layer are changed. According to Brian Swimme and Thomas Berry, the age of the planet is 13.7 billion years. In this period, the living beings on Earth have faced five times near extinction. Now, we are at the threshold of the sixth extinction. The ocean, which is supporting life, is facing challenges today. The global fish landing is getting reduced year after year. There are already 400 dead zones in the sea, which cannot support life. The dead zones are increasing. The life appeared first in the ocean. The death of life in the ocean is a warning to the impending end of life on Earth. Economic and political realities. We live in a world which is economically globalized, but politically nationalized. It means that the boundaries of the countries are closed for the people to migrate, but the companies and corporates can move freely across the national borders. The resources of the developing countries are plundered by the rich nations, but those poor are not allowed to enter the rich countries seeking job and asylum. Therefore, the politics too needs globalization like economy. Hence, for sacred action. The above realities have to be discerned with the lens of faith. What does our faith say about these realities, and what does the Spirit of God impel us to do in order to transform the society according to the plan of God? This discernment needs to be followed by the commitment by the community to a plan of missionary action. Network for mission. The missionary actions have to be done in network in the spirit of shared mission. Within the congregation and with the civil society and with faith-based organizations, we have to work together in order to engage in advocacy and lobbying for the protection of the rights of people and the planet. For engaging in advocacy and campaign mission, now in the congregation, we have a mechanism known as Solidarity and Mission, SOMI, comprised of General JPIC, General Mission Procure, and CMF at UN. In order to work effectively in network, there needs to be at least one representative for SOMI in each community, a group in each major organism, and a group in region. This can enhance the fluent exchange of information from local to the international community and vice versa. This network is already in operation in major parts of the congregation, and it has to be strengthened. Personal credibility. While planning and acting at the levels of community and congregation, the personal life of a missionary needs to bear the marks of compassion. An athlete becomes an accomplished runner primarily by running. So also, we can become good Samaritans by regular practice. Every day, we have to spend an hour in personal contemplative prayer. Every day, we have to do something extra for the needy people, and no day should pass without doing an act of love. Reducing the consumption, reusing and recycling of the resources can make us credible. In order to attract the attention of you, the prefects of apostolates, let me sum up. The JPAC is a regular way of doing mission, and it is transversal in every part of life. For the claret and the congregation, doing this compassionate mission. For us, to take this to the future, we need to grow in contemplation. We have to become aware of the reality around analyze them in the light of Catholic faith and commit for action. The action has to be done in network with civil and faith-based organizations. There is a need to strengthen the SOMI structure, having representation from the level of community to the general SOMI team. Thank you very much.